Hi everyone, Mike Mixon from Keyboardamerica.com here in Lewis Beach, Delaware, and welcome to our Song of the Week in Buttons class. And this week it's Tears on My Pillow. Now, it's always good for you to start on our Song of the Week and Buttons class page on our website, even though it takes you to the YouTube videos, because I frequently do change around icons so you know which videos to watch first. Keep in touch with what we're doing and anything new that's out there. And there's also some great easy play books there. Now, if you do purchase your books through Keyboard America, we can actually email you the chord changes for these songs, and that makes it a lot easier too. So now, this Tears on My Pillow is a great tune, and the chord sequences in here can be used for literally hundreds of songs. So this is a very strategic song that we're doing today. So you'll get a close-up of the chords in my left hand, and we will be deviating on the A minor chord with our fingering from my chord chart, so you want to pay close attention to that. So let's get started. Okay, so reach over, touch your ballad button, and go to page 5 on the ballads and choose 6/8 slow rock 1. Right there. We're going to use our sync start and introduction. You can use intro 1, 2, or 3. Now you're going to learn when you get a close-up of these chord changes how to create your own intro here. Plus you're going to recognize the chord changes for many, many songs. So we're going to start out with intro 2 and let's go hear what the song's supposed to sound like. So I'm sure you recognized those chord changes from many, many songs. Okay, so here's the chord changes. C, A minor. Notice we're moving one finger there. C, A minor, D, G7. And of course that's a D minor, so C, A minor, D minor, G. And let's run through it a little bit real quick so you can see a little bit in real time what we're doing here. In fact, we're going to make our own intro up. So let's press intro 1 and it'll give us a nice drum count. And we'll do our own intro. Ready? Here we go. right there, you can see F major 7. Just move your whole hand up. G7. Don't even move your fingers. Remember, don't be stiff, just in place. Let's look at those chord changes, and here's your D minor, G7, notice my little finger stayed down there, F sharp 7th, we're just going to hit an F sharp here, and right to G instead of G7. You can do either one, but this is pretty easy. Fingers in place. And here we go again. Right there, we're going to use the same chord changes and do a couple other songs just so you can see what I'm talking about. Another great song for this same 6/8 slow rock, and believe me, you could do 100 tunes with this, only you. You might want to do You Belong to Me. Can see all the songs you can do. You might even want to do After the Lovin'. So you can see you can go on and on and on right there with that 6/8 slow rock into almost any year or era. Okay, so on your music at home, you can see we haven't really deviated here too much. Sometimes I'll put a 7th in that A minor, but when we get down to the bottom here, this is where we change the chords. F major 7, G7, F major 7, right there. And of course on the other page, we've added a G7 here, a G7 here, and everything else remained the same. So you can see the little subtle chord changes that we get in this easy play music to even make it sound better like the original hard music would be. All right, so if you watched my other video on how to use your second foot pedal to put your automatic chord on your right hand, I told you that I use my second pedal to turn the vocal harmonies off and on. So what I'm going to do here for you is make your ears hurt and sing a little bit so you can see how nice that pedal is to use while you're playing. And we'll go with intro one again.
You don't remember me, but I remember you. Was not so long ago, you broke
can hear the vocal harmony. When it's off, you have one voice.
When it's on, you have multiple voices. And that's the Alpine Girls vocal harmonies, I called Alpine Girls.
Okay, so I hope I didn't hurt your ears too much there, and you enjoyed this week's lesson on Tears on My Pillow. Stay tuned for more of those great 50s and 60s songs using the same rhythm style. And remember to practice those chord changes, because you can use those chord changes in literally hundreds of songs. So this is Mike Mixon from KeyboardAmerica.com saying have a great day. And also, if you want to go to our Tyros 5 lessons page, just click on the link on your screen and you'll be right there. And remember, it's always good to start there so you see what videos to watch first. Thanks very much. Mike Mixon saying have a great day and keep playing.